Congress passes the most sweeping civil rights bill ever to be written into the law, and thus reaffirms the conception of equality for all men that began with Lincoln and the Civil War 100 years ago. The Negro won his freedom then. He wins his dignity now. 5 hours after the House passes the measure, the Civil Rights Act of 1964 is signed at the White House by President Johnson. Before an audience of legislators and civil rights leaders who had labored long and hard for passage of the bill, President Johnson calls for all Americans to back what he calls a turning point in history.
We must not approach the observance and enforcement of this law in a vengeful spirit. Its purpose is not to punish. Its purpose is not to divide, but to end divisions, divisions which have lasted all too long. Its purpose is national, not regional. This Civil Rights Act is a challenge to all of us to go to work in our communities and our states, in our homes and in our hearts, to eliminate the last vestiges of injustice in our beloved country. So tonight I urge every public official, every religious leader, every business and professional man, every working man, every housewife, I urge every American to join in this effort to bring justice and hope to all our people and to bring peace to our land.
There's warm applause from members of both parties as the president sets to work. It is work. He uses nearly 100 pens to affix his signature and date. Souvenirs go to Republican leader Everett Dirksen and Democratic whip Hubert Humphrey. The president seems to have mastered the art of just touching each pen to the paper. Integration leader Martin Luther King receives his pen, a gift he said he would cherish. The Department of Justice will enforce the law if necessary, and G-Man Chief J. Edgar Hoover is present. Another group of pens is reserved for the Kennedys, and the Attorney General is entrusted with a half dozen. Now, in this summer of 1964, the Civil Rights Bill is the law of the land. In the words of the President, it restricts no one's freedom so long as he respects the rights of others.